In the introduction of Wuthering Heights, Mr. Lockwood, a gentleman from the city, rents Thrushcross Grange, an estate in the wild English countryside, and sets out to meet his landlord, Heathcliff, who lives at Wuthering Heights, an estate across the moors. The residents at Wuthering Heights appear to have no respect for social customs. The weather forces Mr. Lockwood to spend the night in a bedroom there, which turns out to be haunted by a ghost named Cathy. During the rising action, Mrs. Dean, a servant at Thrushcross Grange, recalls Heathcliff's life story. Long ago, Heathcliff, a homeless orphan boy, is brought home by Mr. Earnshaw from a trip to Liverpool. Mr. Earnshaw's children, Cathy and Hindley, despise Heathcliff for being a dark-complexioned gypsy with an ugly temperament. Mr. Earnshaw favors Heathcliff, driving Hindley to violence and hatred. Cathy and Heathcliff become inseparable. Hindley is sent to college and returns with a wife. When Mr. Earnshaw dies, Hindley becomes master of Wuthering Heights and turns Heathcliff into a servant, humiliating and abusing him. One night, Cathy and Heathcliff sneak to Thrushcross Grange to spy on the wealthy Linton children, Isabella and Edgar. When a dog bites Cathy, the children are caught. The Lintons take Cathy in, but send Heathcliff home, rejecting him. Cathy returns weeks later, transformed into an upper-class woman. She and Heathcliff become distant, and Cathy accepts Edgar's marriage proposal, though she confesses her love for Heathcliff to Mrs. Dean. Heathcliff runs away, feeling rejected by Cathy, but returns 3 years later, transformed into a wealthy, attractive gentleman. But he's really returned to take revenge for all the wrongs done to him in childhood. Hindley's wife has died, leaving him to raise their child, Hareton. Hindley has cursed God and become an abusive alcoholic. Heathcliff takes control of Wuthering Heights and manipulates Hareton to love him more than his own father. Heathcliff visits Cathy at Thrushcross Grange and they confess love for each other. Isabella falls for Heathcliff, who exploits her to wreak revenge on Edgar. Heathcliff marries Isabella but abuses her. Cathy is driven to madness when Heathcliff is forbidden to visit her because of a fight between him and Edgar. Pregnant with Edgar's child, Cathy dies after she and Heathcliff have one last passionate meeting in which they berate each other for not staying together. But before she dies, Cathy gives birth to a daughter, Catherine. Isabella runs away, then gives birth to a baby she had with Heathcliff, Linton. Edgar raises Catherine alone at Thrushcross Grange. Hindley dies. Heathcliff raises Hareton alone at Wuthering Heights. Eventually, Catherine meets Hareton. Isabella dies. Linton comes to live at Thrushcross Grange, but Heathcliff demands to raise his own son, so Linton ends up at Wuthering Heights. Linton, a sickly, pampered child, is used by Heathcliff to gain control of Thrushcross Grange. Linton and Catherine marry, and Catherine nurses Linton as he dies. Afterward, she and Hareton, whom Catherine has always disliked, become friends. Haunted by Cathy's memory of 18 years, the climax of the novel sees Heathcliff lose his will to live and decline into an early death, failing to deliver the final blow to complete his revenge. During the falling action, Mrs. Dean recalls to Mr. Lockwood how Heathcliff came to die, and Lockwood leaves. But later, Mr. Lockwood returns to visit, and Catherine and Hareton regain their estates, Thrushcross Grange and Wuthering Heights, and fall in love. In the resolution, they plan to marry on New Year's Day.